a dream I know. Deep up my feelings for you. My people don't be small matter. INEC have instructed the Independent Corrupt Practices and Other Related Offences Commission and the Economic and Financial Crime Commission, EFCC, to target individuals planning to engage in vote buying on the election day in Edo State. Moving on after this, we have... The Edo State government has further addressed the need to postpone the resumption of all schools in Edo State. All right, my wonderful people, welcome back to my wonderful channel, Reality Latest Gist, your home of news and politics. Thank you all so much for joining us on today's wonderful news. To all our amazing subscribers, thank you so much for joining. So if today is your first time watching, kindly subscribe, like, comment, share, but don't forget to turn notification bell to get notified whenever I drop a video, because I'm sure you don't want to miss out the trend and latest news happening on social media. So guys, let's proceed. With 10 days to the Edo State Governorship election, the chairman of the Independent National Electoral Commission, Prof. Mahmoodu Yakubu, has charged security agencies, particularly the Independent Corrupt Practices and Other Related Offences Commission, ICPC, and the Economic and Financial Crime Commission, EFCC, to target individuals planning to engage in vote buying on the election day in Edo State. Yakubu Mahmoodu made the call in Benin City, the Edo State capital, on Tuesday when he met with the members of the Interagency Consultative Committee on Election Securities. He noted that there were interests locally and internationally in the conduct of the Edo State governorship election, while hyping on the importance of collaboration between security agency and the commission. Yakubu Mahmoodu said that such synergy would ensure the election was widely credible and peaceful. He deployed the threat and danger that vote buying posed to Nigeria democratic process, and he urged the ICPC and EFCC to implement effective strategies to combating the menace. He said there's a need to deploy a strategy for combating vote buying, that it has been a feature in the election, and the more INEC improve on the processes, the more some people try to beat the process by now going to buy the vote at the polling unit. Kobu Mahmoodu said that in case if people are trying to buy votes, it means that the votes are counting. That is why they are buying the vote, but they can't allow vote buying to determine who wins their democratic election. That it is a democracy of the people, by the people, for the people, and not plutocracy, which is only open for the rich. On the part of the Edo State Commissioner of Police, Nemo Edwin Iwo, he assured of adequate security before, during, and after the election. He said the police had reviewed and enhanced their strategy for securing the state, and they confirmed that arrangement has been finalized in synergy with other security agencies to deploy enough security personnel from both within Edo State and neighboring states to dominate the space and ensure maximum security throughout the election process. Also, the Commissioner of Police, Edwin Iwo, also assured that non-state actors would not be allowed to undermine the electoral processes, disclosing that security agencies have already initiated actions against groups and individuals who may be plotting to disrupt the election. He said maybe no trial, because this election, the democracy for the people, by the people, must work. They should allow the people to choose the candidate of their choice. So if anyone trying to, you know, initiate vote buying on that election day, they've already instructed the ICPC and the EFCC to take charge. Anything where that person see on that day, now you go collect. So guys, I would like to know your thoughts, your contributions, your opinions are in our comment section. I would love to hear from you. Moving on to the next one. The Edo State government has further addressed the need to postpone the resumption of all schools in Edo State. Last week, the state government indefinitely postponed the resumption of all schools over the petrol price increase. On September 3rd, the National Petroleum Company Limited increased the pump price across the retail outlet to 855. Independent marketers of the product also fixed their prices between 855 and 1000. So the hike has become a major economic challenge experienced by Nigerians. Chris Nikari, Edo State Commissioner to Information, said extending the resumption date was important for the safety of children. Chris Nikari, who spoke on Tuesday, said the state government received reports of a threat against the peace and stability of Edo State. He said some groups are suspected of
hiring hoodlums to disrupt the peace in Edo State. So he added that the schools across the state will remain closed until the situation is diffused. He said this decision was also influenced by the intelligence report indicating that some group had imported armed thugs, posing a threat to a peace and stability of Edo State. So they will not take any chances with their children's safety. That is why they are keeping them at home until the situation is diffused. The commissioner asked academic institutions to remain calm as the government put mechanism in place to make up for the loss of time. My people now will remember last week, the All Progressive Congress in Edo State described what Governor Godwin Obaseki did as a joke. The decision of the state government to suspend resumption date for schools in Edo State over the hike in price of fuel. The permanent secretary in the State Ministry of Education, Ojo Ake, via a memo announced the postponement of September 9, the earlier scheduled date, until further notice. So the APC Publicity Secretary, Peter Owadia, told the news agency of Nigeria that the action of the state government was a political joke, less expected by the public. He said that he was surprised that the state government could be sacrificing the educational pursuits of the children for politics, that they cannot sacrifice the education pursuits of the children for fuel scarcity. So it is not today they are having a hike in fuel prices. This cannot derail the educational system. So nobody is protesting the hike, and no parents have complained that they cannot take their children to school for learning. This is not adding up at all. That to every reasonable and rational individual, the government has earned again. That it is one of the mistakes of the state government. It is not the interest of the children. It is not in the interest of the parents. It is not in the interest of the educational system. So he called for the reversal of the decision, saying that the state education has suffered a lot under his administration, under Governor Godwin Obaseki's administration. So he asked Obaseki that if he now postpone resumption, that how are they going to mitigate the time they have made them stay at home deliberately? Now, meanwhile, the parents are not complaining. Small wala. So now Obaseki talk about content and say, not be about fuel hike. Now about the security aspect, because they have been getting information about the threat. So they don't want make the children they involve. They don't want make anything happen to the children. I mean, this government election, that's why they told them to stay at home first to further notice. So I guess I would like to know your thoughts, your contributions, opinions in our comment section. I would love to hear from you. Once again, thank you so much for staying to us. We do appreciate. On this note, we have come to the end of today's segment. Till I come your way next. Bye for now.